Alright, so with the release of Chapter 5 of Boruto 2 Blue Vortex, I want to dive into the possibilities and outcomes of each of the Shinju's targets. We know that they each have gotten their genetics and distinct desire from the ones that got turned into a tree. It's revealed that they still intend on capturing Boruto and Kawaki, but their primary objective now is to discover their identity and individuality by picking a target coming from their innate feeling and originating from those who got turned into a tree. So, Sasuke's Shinju version, which we get to know as Itari, targets Sarada. Matsuri, who has the genetics of Moegi, has targeted Konohamaru. Bug, whose Shinju name has yet to be revealed, has apparently targeted Eita as he saw through her Sanrigan while she was listening in on their conversation, and he straight up told her and decided there that she was his target. And finally, Jiraiya has surprisingly decided to target Naruto. So it appears that for the most part, they are targeting their victims based on their instinctual desire, which is basically the strong affection or feeling their originals had for a person which appears to be of love. Now it's here I present the power scaling or ranking bar I have made for myself. It's basically something that measures characters to see how strong they are and where they stand from 1 to 10. 1 being Jigen and 10 being Ishiki. Although it might be largely theory-based, I've tried to align it with the story so that it makes sense. So I wanted to make this topic into 4 separate parts as there will be a lot to go into and cover for each part. So, starting with Hidari vs. Sarada. Now this would make for a truly interesting fight, man. She mainly uses lightning style and fire style techniques. She has her mother's strength and her father's intelligence. And she must have grown a lot stronger during the time skip. Now I would say her trump card would definitely be her Mangekyo Sharingan, which she probably must have extensively tested and mastered during the time skip. Now I'm not gonna get into its abilities that much, as we haven't seen anything yet and that discussion would heavily be theory based. Now if we're talking about Base Sarada won't be able to take him down on her own, man. Even if we ignore the mental nerf she'll probably get when she sees Sasuke and Hidari, she won't be able to take an Otsutsuki level opponent down unless she has a broken Mangekyo, cause mind you, we still haven't seen how powerful it is and neither its abilities. So as of now, without factoring in her Mangekyo, but counting in 3 years of training, I would honestly put Base Sarada below Code. Now, I'm talking about Code from 3 years ago, with limiters. I would say between Koji and Code in her base. Now, it's a no-brainer that Sarada will continue to progress and develop. Some obvious milestones, if she hasn't already reached them, would be mastering her Mangekyo abilities, the Susanoo, unlocking the Byakugo seal, and something that I need to see from Sarada is to actually form her own ninjutsu, man. Just like Boruto and Naruto, her role model have done it. Each milestone will of course elevate her on the power scale. So yeah, in my opinion, Sarada in her base without Mangekyo would be on par with Kashin, Koji and Code, meaning she hasn't reached number 1 in the bar, i.e. Jigen level. But regardless of that, we saw how Koji went toe to toe against Jigen. So she is nevertheless close to that level. But hear me out, man, we saw what the Shinju version of Bug did to Boruto. He was on par with Boruto to the point that he had to use the flying Raichu. Now, I do actually believe that that same Boruto could still be Bug in a 1v1. But that's beside the point, man. The point is that they are strong as hell, man. Now, the original Bug, he was literally the weakest character in the story. And we know that the Shinjus embody their originals, though multiplies that by an indefinite number as it seems. For example, we never saw Bug with the ability to elongate his hands and transform it as the Shinju clone was able to. But let's say, man, even if the original Bug had the ability, which is highly unlikely, the fact still remains that their strength and ability increase significantly. Now, if we remove Jura from the picture, whose identity we still don't know, who do you think would be the strongest amongst Bug, Moegi and Sasuke? Of course it's Sasuke. Now, give him 2 Rinnegans, massive boost in strength, and Code's claw mark, and we have someone who literally is the likes of Jigen for dinner, man. Now, if Limiter's Code from 3 years ago was stronger than Jigen, that would put him above 1. But I would prefer to say it's a range between 2 and 3. Now, give that same man 3 years to work with his newly found power. That would obviously put him even further on the list. It's maybe generous of me, but I would put him on 6 and no higher than that, since it's unlikely for him to fully train, as he's often full of himself. And by the way, I am putting 6 on the current code, with activated karma and no limiters. And we saw how Boruto demolished him with the help of Uzuhiko. So these are just my assumptions, but I would say base Boruto, not counting in Uzuhiko, would be between 4 and 5. With Uzuhiko, I would give him an 8, man. And with Karma, I would bump him up to a 10+, meaning above Ishiki. But now coming back to what I was saying earlier, although Boruto was kind of caught off guard, Bug still went toe-to-toe against base Boruto. So factoring in all of that, I would rank Bug between 5 and 6, man. A C, in my opinion, would decimate the likes of base code and would be an equal to maybe a code with activated karma. But if he is like a 5 to 6 in the bar, I would say Hidari would be even higher. So I would therefore give Hidari an 8 to 9, bringing us to our conclusion. So, do I think Sarada can do it by herself? Hell no. Well, not even with the help of Mitsuki, or hell, bring even the entire Naruto gen back, they could not touch the likes of Hidari, man. Maybe besides 8-gear Rockley and Kakashi, cause we really haven't seen much of them and we haven't seen how they have developed during the time skip. But that's a big maybe though. Base Sarada, in my opinion, is like a range between -2 and -1. Cause I don't see base Sarada beating the likes of Jigen, man. Which also means it would be crazy, according to my theory, for her to take Hidari down by herself without anyone's help. Now, if we bring her Mangekyo to the picture, that could possibly be her winning route and bump her above Jigen and around Ichiki's level depending on his ability. But I would say a more realistic way for her to defeat Hidari would be with the help of Boruto. And since he's already in the village, it would make sense for this fight to be a Boruto Sarada versus Hidari situation. By the way, they are revealed as strong, but never stronger than Ishiki. It would make sense that at least the most powerful one or the leader would be stronger than Ishiki as the new enemy after 3 years. It makes sense narratively. However, when it comes to Boruto power scaling, it's very difficult, man. I had this video finished, but I then had to change the power scaling of it. So I've had some variations and I have differed about how far each character have come within the scale or bar I've created. My initials was much different than my current stance. I would say I'm more comfortable in saying that they have reached Ishiki level than before, and it also makes sense, as previously said, that a new enemy is often stronger than a previous one. That's it, man. Thank you for listening. Do let me know whether you like this kind of style and the so-called ranking bar. And I'm still feeling things out, so I might change up some stuff as well. Stay tuned for part 2. That's what I'm gonna say. Peace.